Lightworkers Media presents the Bible Series Podcast, a dramatization of Bible stories honoring the spirit of the book. Episode 1, Change the World.
Ancient Israel, the land promised by God to the Jewish people, is now occupied by the iron fist of the Roman Empire. Caesar maintains order with brutal enforcement through regional governors. Unrest simmers throughout the land. Jewish authorities walk a razor's edge between appeasing Rome and calming the growing rebellion among its people. The most faithful among the Jews cry out for the long-promised Messiah, a new King David who will come to free them from Roman rule. But there has been no prophet for 400 years, no message from God, no word of hope. Has God forgotten his people? They ask again and again, "How long, O Lord?" Rome has taken direct control of Jerusalem and Judea. Herod Antipas, the Jewish tetrarch of Galilee, awaits the arrival of the fourth Roman governor in 20 years, the arrogant and ruthless Pontius Pilate.
Greetings, Prefect. Welcome to Judea. I hope your time here will be prosperous and peaceful.
I intend to make sure it is.
Orders from Caesar. This descent must stop.
For Pilate and Herod Antipas, any gathering of people is a threat.
Repent, and your sins shall be forgiven!
At the River Jordan, crowds flock to hear a man called John the Baptist, a fiery preacher from the wilderness. With undeniable authority, he calls the people to repentance. Wearing clothes made of camel's hair, he reminds them of Elijah from ancient times. Could this man also be a prophet? Could God be breaking his silence? Or is this just the kind of agitator Pontius Pilate seeks to quash?
I baptize you, ready for the new kingdom. As you are cleansed, so all Israel shall be cleansed. All flesh shall see the salvation of God.
Far away from the desert, at the palace, Pilate gets down to business and questions Herod Antipas.
You said there was trouble.
In the desert, the people are flocking to this wild man, John. They think he's a prophet. Some even call him the Messiah.
And what is a Messiah?
The Redeemer of the Jews, anointed by God to set them free.
Then you need to keep an eye on your Messiah.
A cloaked traveler walks alone along the banks of the Jordan River. He seems unassuming. He looks just like another pilgrim seeking John's baptism.
There is one to come, greater than me, who will baptize with fire. I am just a voice in the wilderness, preparing the way for the...
John catches sight of the traveler as he makes his way through the crowd towards him. On the surface, the man is merely a carpenter from the town of Nazareth. But John sees something more, something holy. The man's name is Jesus.
John, what you are doing is right. Baptize me.
Lord, I need you to baptize me.
But obediently, John lowers Jesus into the water and raises him up again. At that moment, the clouds seem to stir in the sky as if the heavens themselves have opened. The Spirit of God comes down like a dove and rests upon Jesus. Suddenly, a voice from heaven says, "This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased." After his baptism, Jesus is led by the Holy Spirit into the wilderness. He does not eat for 40 days. His spirit is tested in preparation for the challenges to come. Exhausted and hungry, he collapses onto the dirt under the blistering sun. He senses that someone is approaching and struggles to his feet to face the stranger. But Jesus recognizes his enemy. He knows his real test is just beginning.
Satan, if you were Son of God, command that this stone becomes bread.
Satan tosses a stone to Jesus. In the hands of Jesus, the stone could easily become bread. For a starving man, the temptation is great.
Man shall not live by bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God.
But Satan is not so easily thwarted. Suddenly, he takes Jesus to the pinnacle of the temple. Here, Satan dares Jesus to prove that God will not allow any harm to come to him.
If God loves you, throw yourself down. His angels will lift you up in their hands. How dare you put God to the test?
Satan persists, looking steadily at Jesus, getting to the heart of what he's really after.
If you will bow down and worship me, I will give you the whole world.
This is Jesus' greatest test yet. He knows that someday he will be the ruler over all the kingdoms of the world, but not now, not this way. There will be no shortcuts. Jesus has a greater destiny to fulfill.
Get away from me, Satan. I worship the Lord, my God, and serve him only.
The evil presence vanishes. Jesus has resisted Satan's temptations. Strengthened and ready, he can now begin his mission. But it will be without John the Baptist.
We thank you for listening to the Redemption of the Passion Story through the Bible Son of God podcast. By listening to this series, there is no doubt that you are enthusiastic about the pursuit of knowledge, a true lifelong learner. You recognize the value of enhancing your understanding of the world around you. People such as yourself are always searching for ways to enrich their lives, and audiobooks are a great way to do so. They help you become a better, more inspired you. Whether you want to feel healthier, get motivated, or just learn something new, there's something for everyone on Audible. Audible lets you listen to an unmatched selection of audiobooks, original audio shows, news, and more. You can switch seamlessly between devices, picking up exactly where you left off, which means you can get through tons of content while doing almost anything. Start a 30-day trial, and your first audiobook is free. We recommend starting with Mere Christianity, which brings together C.S. Lewis's legendary radio broadcasts during the war years. It's an incredibly unique listen, providing an unequaled opportunity for believers and non-believers alike to absorb a powerful, rational case for the Christian faith. Well, what are you waiting for? Go to audible.com/Bible or text Bible to 500-500 to start your 30-day trial and get your first audiobook free. That's audible.com/Bible or text Bible to 500-500. Today, over a million people use the amazing Ring Video doorbell to help protect their homes. It's incredible. If someone rings your doorbell and you aren't home or don't want to come to the front door, you can respond to the person using just your smartphone. Well, now, Ring has a great new product called Ring Floodlight Cam. Just like Ring's amazing doorbell, their Floodlight Cam is a motion-activated camera and floodlight with HD video and two-way audio that lets you know the moment anyone steps onto your property. You can see and speak to visitors, even set off a built-in alarm right from your phone. You know, getting mine set up was a snap, and it gave me immediate peace of mind. You can't put a price tag on that. Together, the Ring Video doorbell and floodlight cam put security in your hands, whether you're home or away. Simply put, with Ring, you're always home. Right now, as a listener of this show, you can save up to $150 off a Ring of Security kit when you go to ring.com/Bible. Up to $150 off at ring.com/Bible. That's ring.com/Bible.
Come on, scum! Get in!
John the Baptist has been arrested by Herod Antipas for openly criticizing him. Herod Antipas watches without emotion as the prophet is beaten. Jesus arrives at a cove on the Sea of Galilee. As he surveys the clear blue lake and the people who toil along the edge of the water, his eyes are filled with purpose. He approaches a fisherman who's tying up his boat for the day.
Do you need help?
I'm not looking for any help. And besides, there's nothing to help with.
The man shows Jesus his empty baskets and nets. Jesus steps into the water and wades to the man's boat.
Hey, what are you doing? You can't just climb into my boat.
Yeah, you're right. Give me a helping hand.
Irritated, the fisherman reluctantly helps Jesus into the boat.
What do you think you're doing?
We're going fishing.
There are no fish out there this time of day. In fact, there are no fish out here any time of day.
Peter, just give me an hour, and I will give you a whole new life.
Who says I want one? I tell you, there's no fish out there.
Jesus merely smiles at Peter's skepticism. Peter, unsure of what to do with the stranger, begins to work the sails to take the boat back out into deeper water. Not far away, in his prison cell, a beaten and bloody John the Baptist is not afraid of Herod Antipas, nor of the executioner's blade.
What am I going to do with you? You and your dangerous mouth.
Listen.
To a seditious fool? I don't think so.
To God's message, the kingdom of heaven is near.
So you do claim to be the Messiah?
No.
But you think he's coming?
No. He's already here. He's here.
Then he will bring a new age of righteousness and justice. His power will draw all men to a new world. All people!
John's words worry Herod Antipas. This is more trouble than he cares to deal with. He hopes John's death will put a stop to it. But it won't, because John was the herald, the forerunner, sent to prepare the way for the promised one. Jesus is out on the water with Peter. Peter watches as Jesus leans over the side and simply touches the surface of the lake. Suddenly, Peter struggles to draw in net after net of wriggling fish. The baskets fill up. Finally, Peter falls back against the mast, exhausted and amazed.
How did this happen? What did you do?
I'm giving you the chance to change your life. Peter, come with me. Give up catching fish and I will make you a fisher of men.
What are we gonna do? Change the world.
The Bible Series podcast is a production of Lightworkers Media, narrated by Roma Downey. Produced by Dan Collins and Jamie Owens Collins. Executive produced by Roma Downey and Catherine Warnock. Script adapted by Jamie Owens Collins with Paul McCusker. Music by Hans Zimmer. Digital audio design and editing by Steve Hallmark and Dan Collins. With thanks to Diogo Morgado as Jesus and the entire cast and crew. Special thanks to Richard Bedzer. I'm Steve Gibbons. Find more at lightworkers.com.